Hello, beautiful Starseed. Welcome back to another lesson with Starseed Academy. My name is Jenny and I help Starseed and lightworkers from all over the world to heal their energy, activate their earthly mission, and to reconnect with their spirit guides. In today's lesson, I want to talk about a transitional period that we will likely all go through, and there's probably a lot of you, including myself, going through this right now. And that's how to deal with losing friends. This is such a difficult experience to go through, yet it's actually very common and even necessary along your ascension path. As you change and transform, your energy and your vibes, everything about you, it changes too. So you really are making a huge transformation by raising your vibration. You're just changing everything. Your life path, your course, the things that you're attracted to, the things that are attracted to you. And that has to do with people and friends and relationships of all kinds. So we're all probably going to run into this at one point on our journey, or maybe even multiple points along the journey, where you kind of outgrow your friends. I mean, is that bad to say? No, it's not. Is that hard to deal with? Yes, very. Sometimes it feels like a breakup and can last months, and there's a whole grieving period that you go through where you ask yourself, am I doing the right thing? Is this really what's for the best? And you really have to trust your heart and your gut with this. We all grow at different rates. If you had someone that you truly loved and cared for, you wouldn't want to hold them back. And it's not that you would be doing it intentionally, it's that the energies just don't go together anymore and they don't support each other, and that's just a fact. So if you're vibrating at a completely different frequency, then a group of friends or a single friend or a relationship even, then you owe it to yourself to surround yourself with the things that do support you and do inspire you and do lift you up. And you'll know that this is happening when you spend time with this person. Afterwards, ask yourself honestly, do I feel lifted up and refreshed and full of energy and excitement about my future and like very excited to get out there and live life? Or do I feel just the opposite, completely drained, exhausted, discouraged, lack of energy, tired, grumpy? Again, it's not that this person, this friend, or this relationship is intentionally trying to hold you back or deplete you of your energy. It's that if two people are vibrating at completely different frequencies, then they are always going to affect each other. You are affected by everything that you surround yourself with, especially the people that you surround yourself with. So if you're vibrating at a higher level of self-awareness and self-consciousness and determination, and you hang out with people that are down here, you're going to be pulled down. Like, there's no other way to say it. It's going to affect you and pull on your energy in an exhausting way. You just feel like you just don't vibe with them anymore. Like, you hang out with them and after the hangouts, you're kind of just like, just doesn't feel the same anymore. I just don't feel that bond. We're just not vibing. We're just not connecting. Like, I just feel off. And then if you continue to hang out with them, it's going to progress further and further. Like, oh, I don't feel good after hanging out with them. I really didn't enjoy that. Or I feel tired, or I feel exhausted, or feeling like, you know, I don't agree with a lot. It's going to get more and more extreme if you continue to try to force the relationship. If you're being really honest with yourself and you really are self-aware on this journey to spiritual awakening, raising your vibration, you're interested in ascension and you're interested in making a difference in the world, chances are you're a highly aware and sensitive person. You know if someone is not vibing with you, if they're bringing you down, if they're giving you side looks, if you're feeling drained. All of these are symptoms of two people on two different paths, and that is okay. You need to respect each other and each other's paths, even when it's difficult to let go, to kind of just phase that out of your life for the time being. It doesn't mean that you can't come back to it later or that you might not meet up again later, but currently, if it's not supporting you during this extremely important time on the planet of transformation, we all need to try to be at our highest and our best, because we're here to make a difference in the world. And in order to do that, you need to make a difference in yourself, in your own life, and you need to model that after what you want to see in the world. So sometimes that means making hard decisions, and that's okay. You're not a bad person. It's okay to have something bigger than yourself be that important to you and be your mission. And if you're a starseed, well, you came here with the mission. It was born into you. And there's not much you can do about that, nor would you even really want to if it came right down to it. So even though it's really difficult and we are so sensitive to these emotions of not wanting to hurt someone or hurt their feelings, you don't have to be confrontational at all. You really can just kind of phase yourself out of what's not working for you, just like you would with like other things in your life, music, entertainment, food. If you start to find something's not working for you and it's making you sick, bringing you down, you start to phase it out. You can do that with people too. You should do that with people too. So this is on you to be very aware in your own life and within yourself, to take responsibility for your life, to be the creator of your life, and to know that nobody but you is going to make these tough decisions. It's going to make these important decisions that are going to result in your vibration either raising or not raising. And what's more important to you right now? You're going to get to a point in your life where that is the most important thing to you. And that's amazing. That's your mission. That's beautiful. Go with that. Now we know losing friends happens. It can go from you phasing them out, them phasing you out, whatever it is. When you start not to vibe with someone, I know it's painful, but do not feel alone. This happens to all of us, and it hurts every single time. It literally is like a breakup. So how do we deal with losing friends? How do we accept that? Let's talk about five different ways that you can deal with it. So the first one is to be grateful for who you already have. So I'm really hoping truly with all of my heart that you have at least one person in your life that loves you and that you love unconditionally and that supports you in everything. Maybe that's your mom or dad, maybe that's your spouse, maybe that's a sibling, but I really truly hope that you have at least one person. And if you don't fret. That person is coming to you. But for now, you need to turn within to your higher self to be that best friend for you. I've gone through times in my life where I was my own best friend. That's okay. I got through that time and I was stronger and more resilient because of it. So there's got to be someone that you can be grateful for, even if that's yourself or a pet that you have. But for most of us, we have at least one parent or sibling or one member of our family somewhere in there that truly loves us unconditionally, even when we're being weird starseed. They kind of just, okay, I love you anyway. They may not get it, but they're certainly not bringing you down in any way. So that's someone you can be grateful for. Maybe a cat or a dog or a pet or something. They're awesome too, like cat magic. But if you find someone to be grateful for, you're creating that emotion of gratitude in your tomorrow and in the next day after that and the day after that. The way you feel now creates your tomorrow and creates your future life. So be grateful now so that you can continue to feel grateful later. Just please don't underestimate gratitude. It is just so important, and that's why it's tip number one. Tip number two is to spend your time wisely. So maybe you don't have a lot of friends right now. That's okay. That means you've got extra time and you should be spending that time developing your own spiritual awareness and your own spiritual journey, because that's why this is happening anyway. So you might as well devote some time to that. Start to learn who you are, remember who you are, what you're here for, figure out your mission, and develop a plan, a pathway to that mission with easy, reachable steps. Research is an amazing thing. I remember spending lots of time, especially at the beginning of my journey, or during times when I found myself alone. Instead of feeling lonely, I used that time productively towards my future, doing more card readings, or maybe I'm doing more Reiki healing on myself, more meditations, or finding books about starseed, finding information online about ascension, or finding people online that I vibed with and them being like a virtual friend. I've had a lot of different YouTube channels help me out, really helped me to get through difficult times when I was feeling like really lonely or like the only one going through this. And we're just not. There's so many people going through this, either in the exact same place you're in or a little bit ahead of you or a little bit behind you. So it's just finding someone that's gonna vibe for you and give you the information you need, send out the energy that you're needing to encourage you along your path, lift you up, bring you to the next level in your ascension, because we are always changing so quickly. So for me, I absolutely adore Victor Otto. His YouTube channel is authentic and so like raw and real and genuine. And even though we've never met, I consider Vic a good friend of mine. So find someone like that for you that works, that you can see is on the same path as you. Maybe where you're at or a little bit ahead would be ideal to help you to continue to keep reaching. And there's just something about hearing like stories and examples from someone's life that coincide so closely with your own. It's just really encouraging. To sum up tip number two, spending your time that you know how, spend it surrounding yourself and immersing yourself with content and people that encourage your progress and encourage your ascension and transformation process. If that's why all of this is happening and changing in your life, then you might as well embrace it. And knowledge is power. So do the research. Do the self-work. You've got the time. Now's the time to do it. Basically, become the friend that you want to attract. Whatever it is that you're looking for in a friend, become that. And that's exactly what you're going to attract into your life. So that's what you could do when you're feeling like you have a lot of extra time on your hands. Instead of feeling sorry for yourself or feeling lonely, become the new friend that you want in your life. Okay, so tip number three is to relearn who you even are. So we kind of stepped on this tip's toes in tip two.
That's like a tongue twister.
Tip two, toes, tip.
Okay. Why are you going through this cycle of relationships? Why are things, not just friends, but other things that you used to be interested in, falling away and you no longer have that attraction to them anymore? And sometimes there can be a space in between the old things falling away and the new things coming in, and there's this kind of like blank empty space, and that's where we can get that fear that nothing's gonna come in and fill it, or that loneliness. But it is temporary, like a passing through on your way. And in the interim, it's really important to get to know who you are, because you have likely changed so much. Think right now about who you were 5 years ago, 2 years ago, 1 year ago, 6 months ago. Like, I am just not that person. I am just changing too rapidly to have a lot of people consistently with me. And just know that who you are now is still gonna change. So ideally, you wanna look for someone who's on a path of transformation too. And self-aware people, spiritually awakened people, do treat this life as a journey to their best versions of themselves. And so they will be consistently transforming and changing and striving and learning and falling and getting back up, and it's epic. Those are the kinds of souls that you want to surround yourself with. So get to know who you are right now. This is your time. It's also a huge part of self-love too. You really have to know who you are to love yourself. And I find that the more I reflect on who I was, to who I am, to where I want to be, the more I realize just how much I've been through and just how much I've changed and transformed. And I'm really proud of that. Like, I've really overcome a lot, and I'm guessing you have too. We should be proud of that. We should love ourselves. Let's all do tip three tonight and relearn who we are and fall in love with this new version of ourselves. Tip number four is to get out and try new things. authentic things, but new things. Join a yoga class. I tried aerial yoga for the first time, and that was amazing, hanging from the ceiling and turning upside down, and it wasn't something that I had done before. Or take a card reading class or a crystal information class, or try out a new bookshop that you haven't been to yet. These are the places that you're going to meet those souls that you're looking for. You're not going to meet any new friends or relationships sitting at home just being by yourself. There's a point in your journey where you need to actually push yourself outside of your alone time and open yourself up to meeting new people. So go take a meditation class. Go do something that is authentic, represents you, pushes you outside of your normal space of comfort, and involves a group of like-minded people. What better way to meet people, right? And the last tip for how to deal with losing friends is to be patient, because we all go through this and no one particularly likes it. Breakups aren't fun. Being alone isn't always fun. And there's a deep need to feel seen and heard and understood by someone. But you shouldn't be settling for just anyone. That's not good enough anymore. That's not gonna do. So you're gonna be patient, and you're gonna wait for the right people. And because you do that and you become discerning like that and you set the bar for what you allow into your life based on your self-worth, you set that bar high for who is allowed to come into your life and partake of your precious time, because that is such a precious commodity while we're here on this mission, is our time and how we spend it. So be discerning. Don't hang out with a bunch of gossip queens or people that are constantly negative or putting others down. These are all red flags. You deserve to have friends with the same values that you have, that treat others the way that they want to be treated, that rise above drama and gossip, that love Mother Earth and support her through their actions, that treat animals with respect and love, that are self-aware and growing towards something, that are not just stagnant. And one of the most important qualities, that when they come across others that they don't resonate with, that they don't condemn them and judge them, that they don't make fun of other people. It's just not okay. We're all made different, and there's no reason to be bullying people in the background of their lives or talking about someone who's not there. That's their character coming out, and it's just not okay. I feel really passionate about that. And I feel really uncomfortable when I get put in a situation with a group of people and they continually turn the conversation to gossip and putting others down or making fun of others, regardless of who they're talking about. It's never okay. It's absolutely a reflection on the person doing the harassment or the disrespect. It doesn't impress me. And I know you feel the same way. So just keep your eyes open, your ears open, your heart open. Be discerning. Don't settle. Phase out what you need to phase out. Spend your time, your precious time, doing things that enrich you and your life. And just know that that friend is out there and they are growing towards you as you are growing towards them. Your soul family is absolutely coming into your life very soon. 2019 is a year of mass awakening. So many people are waking up right now and looking for others to help them and get together and support each other on their journey. They're out there. If we are, they are. So yeah, that old high school drama is just not gonna cut it anymore. We've grown past that. Always remember to act like the person that you want in your life. Always remember that the way that you are acting and the vibrations and the energy that you're putting off are going to be reflected back to you. So be respectful, be classy, be kind. And in the meantime, I am more than happy to hang out with you, all of my beautiful star seeds. I can just feel your love. And I'm sending you back like rainbows and rainbows of love. I so appreciate you and everything that you do. Thank you so much for every single subscriber, every single comment, everyone on Instagram, all of the shout outs in my DMs. It means everything. It's showing me and all of us that we're ready for this. And we're all ready for this big change. We are all ready for more. So ask more of yourself and you'll get more from others. Anyway, I love you so much. Thank you again for joining me. I am just beyond blessed to get to know so many amazing people in this world. And the internet is an incredible tool that we can use to make this world a better place, that we can use to connect with each other and share joyfulness and growth and energies and transmissions of this spiritual revolution that is taking off right now. Use the power for good. If you have any comments about how you've dealt with losing friends, leave those below so that we can all encourage each other. And it also shows others that they're not alone, that they're not the only one going through this. If you open yourself up and share like that, you will be rewarded for it. So that's what I believe, and that's why I share on this channel for starseeds who are going through this incredibly dramatic journey to help others to see that they are not alone. But you know what comes next, because you need to listen to your heart and the quiet voice within, because you are so much more than the body you are in. Bye.